Now we'll discuss about Shannon's limit. Shannon's limit is a generic name representing the fundamental performance limit of transmission. In short, it is the maximum rate that you can send data through a channel with a given bandwidth and given noise level. If you exceed the channel capacity, you can expect to have some data loss. Consider an ideal system. An ideal system is one in which the rate of transmission RB equal to C. The rate of transmission is equal to the channel capacity. Now, we know that the average transmitted signal power, S equal to EB into RB. So, since the system is ideal, this can be written as S equal to EB. Since RB equal to C, this can be written as SC equal to EBC, where EB is the transmitted energy per bit and C is the channel capacity. Now, we know that C equal to B log to the base 2 1 plus S by N0B, right? So, we know that SC equal to EBRB, which is equal to EBC, since this is an ideal system. So, this can be written as B log 1 plus EBC by N0B. Right. So, this is C. So, C by B. So, C by B can be written as log 2 1 plus EBC by N0B. Now, I am converting log to the base 2 to the ln function. That is, log 2x can be written as ln x by ln 2. So, this can be written as ln 1 plus EBC by N0B divided by ln 2, that is C by B. Now, this can be written as C by B into ln 2, that is C by B into ln 2 equal to ln 1 plus EBC by N0B, or ln 2 raised to C by B equal to ln 1 plus EBC by N0B. So, removing ln from both sides, you can write it as 2 raised to C by B equal to 1 plus EBC by N0B. Or EB by N naught can be written as 2 raised to C by B minus 1 divided by C by B. Where EB by N naught is energy per bit to noise spectral density ratio and C by B is bandwidth efficiency. Earlier, we assumed an ideal system in which transmission rate RB is equal to the channel capacity, right? Now, we will consider a practical system in which the transmission rate RB less than C. We know that the capacity of a band limited, power limited continuous channel is given by C equal to B log 1 plus S by N0B, right? So, for a practical system, the maximum transmission rate is, let it be RB, right? So, we can write it as RB equal to B log 1 plus, we know that S is EB RB, right? So, EB RB by N0B. Or this can be written as RB by B equal to log 1 plus EB RB by N0B. Now, if you try to plot RB by B versus EB by N0, we will get a plot like this. So, this is RB by B and this is EB by N0. So, this is also in dB and this is also in dB. Here, RB by B, we will call it as rate bandwidth. and EB by N out is energy per bit to noise spectral density ratio. So here we can see that this boundary, we will call it as the capacity boundary, that is RB equal to C. This we will call it as capacity boundary. So this is the region where RB less than C, and this is the region where RB greater than C. We know that this particular region where we will not prefer for transmission, because here we can see that this is RB greater than C. We know that by Shannon's second theorem, the rate of transmission should be within the capacity of the channel, right? So we will not prefer this region of operation. We prefer only this region of operation. Now we will consider two scenarios in which one is bandwidth limited operation and power limited operation. In bandwidth limited operation, we have a limited bandwidth, right? So RB by B is very much greater than 1 means the region of operation will be in this direction. We need to operate the channel in this region, that is RB less than C. Then only error-free transmission possible. Here only error-free transmission is possible. And here, since RB is very much RB greater than C, error-free transmission not possible. So, in the case of bandwidth limited operation, RB by B is very much greater than 1. So, we will operate in this region. So, as a result, we need a large value of EB by N out is required for operating the channel in RB less than C region or error-free transmission. So, this scenario is preferred when we have a limited bandwidth in our position. So, now consider the case of power limited operation. As in the case of deep space communication. So, in this case, we have a limited power with us, a higher bandwidth. So, in this case, we have RB very much less than B. That is, we have larger amount of bandwidth with us. So, the region of operation will be in this direction. So, we can see that we need lower EB by N naught is required for error-free transmission. Now, we need to find the minimum EB by N naught required for error-free transmission. We need to find the minimum EB by N naught required for error-free transmission. So, this happens when B is, or the bandwidth will be infinity. So, for infinite bandwidth channel, we know that C infinity will be equal to 1.44 S by N0, right? Again, we know that SC equal to EBRB or EBC infinity, right? Or C infinity equal to 1.44 EBC infinity by N0, or EB by N0 will be equal to, so this will cancel, and EB by N0 will be equal to 1 by 1.44. This will be equal to approximately equal to 0.693. So in dB, now EB by N0 in dB will be equal to minus 1.6 dB. So we can say that this is the minimum EB by N0 required for error-free transmission. So that will be, so when the bandwidth will be infinity, you will go beyond this point, and the amount of EB by N0 required will be this value, then it will be given by minus 1.6 dB. So this will be the zero value. That is EB by N naught equal to minus 1.6 dB happens when B tends to infinity. And this value of EB by N naught is called Shannon's limit. Now let's have a quick recap. In the case of bandwidth limited operation, a large value of EB by N naught is required to keep RB less than C. That is, you need a large average power is required. So in the case of a power limited operation, as in the case of a deep space communication, so we have a large bandwidth compared to the bit rate, so that only the minimum signal power is required.